That describe places or something like this, Disneyland, you know, kind of some kind of, like, describe the environment. One thing I noticed that was not true is this right here. No cats in heaven. Sorry, that's keep that in your head. And it's not just me, it's not me that's saying that. It's actually C.S. Lewis. Here's what he said. It's possible to have a heaven for cats and a hell for humans all in the same place. That's what C.S. Lewis. And 5 years ago, I could have gotten away with that quote. But you're probably going to Google it and realize that it lied. It actually says mosquitoes. C.S. Lewis actually said mosquitoes, and I just changed it to cats. But it works. The same thing. So what's happened if you are? When I ask that question, like I said, people, you know, like talk about the environment, like this tasteful decorations and this exquisite, you know, floor coverings and stuff. Really has nothing to do with that. It has way more to do with who we are and who we're going to become. And the community that we're going to celebrate together than it has to do with the carpeting and the wallpaper. Have you been camping? How many of you have been camping? How many of you had a leaky tent? Maybe the worst thing in the world when it comes to camping, right? You have no dry place to go. And it was camping, and we had a leaky tent, and just kind of feel that, you know, you feel it just can't get dry. I would rather spend eternity in a leaky tent with people that are full of grace and joyful and selfless. Then I would like to spend eternity in a mansion full of people who are judgmental and self-centered, bitter. Now we're going to look, and John's going to lead us through some stuff as we look at Revelation 3. And we're going to look, and what he's going to describe is not the wallpaper and the carpet. What he's going to describe is who we will become, and then the kind of community that we'll create together. It's this amazing vision that God's placing in our lives and our hearts. Because it's not some place, somewhere that he's worried about. He's worried about this transformation that can start right here, right now. And so kind of our phrase to wrap up this series is this. What makes heaven heaven is not the wallpaper and the carpet. It's who I'll be with and who I'll become. That's the bottom line, the vision, the picture that I want you to get. And you know, for some of us, it's going to be encouraging. Some of us, it's going to be this sense of like, oh, that's where God wants me to go. That's where I'm heading. For some of us, it might be a little discouraging. But you know what I know? The reality is that when we talk about heaven, it's not the destination for every person in this room. I wish it was. But there's people in this room who've never been in a relationship with God through His Son, Jesus Christ. And you know what? A relationship with Jesus Christ is what heaven's about. And I have friends that tell me I'm narrow-minded for thinking like that. But here's something struck me as I drove out. I live on a cul-de-sac, and I was driving out the other day, and there's like a little sign that's like, you know, no outlet on my street. And I realized, you know what? When I give people directions to my house, and I say, you have to go on 38, and you have to turn left onto Quail. That's the only way to get to my house. I'm not being narrow-minded, right? I'm just trying to give accurate directions. And so my hope is if you're in this room and you've never entered a relationship with God through His Son, Jesus Christ, as you look at what we're talking about, and God casts this vision of what heaven's going to be like, that it would just communicate to you, this is God's agenda for you. One of the things that keeps my friends, some of them, away from a relationship with Jesus is because they think He's got some hidden agenda. Like if I say yes to Him, He's going to ruin my life. But what we're going to see over the next few minutes is that it's completely opposite of that. So, here's what our hope is. It's been this way from the beginning of this Revelation series, that Jesus would reveal Himself to you in a way that maybe He hasn't before, and we would understand how our story fits into this story. We are on board for that? All right, let's open up then to Revelation chapter 21. If you have your Bibles, grab it. Open up to Revelation 21.